Namaskar, dear learners. I, C. Ankur Kumar, welcome you all to the studio of NIOS. Today, we will discuss about computer and computerized accounting system. So what are the objectives when I talk about computer and computer accounting systems? Number one, description of the computer and its limitations. Second, explaining the role of the computer in accounting. Third, differentiated between manual accounting and computerized accounting. Fourth, explaining the accounting information system. Fifth, description of the basic requirements of the computerized accounting and the sourcing of the accounting systems. Just imagine when there was no computers. However, the accounts would have been prepared from the many past. Previously, the accounts would have been prepared in bahi khata. So just imagine voluminous books of accounts, voluminous manual accounting entries, and for example, there would have been any errors in the books of recording an accounting entry, how the same has been could be rectified. After implementation of the computer in India, there has been more implementation towards the accounting entries through computers and computer services. So let's now discuss about how it has changed our accounting process. What is computer? All of us know about computer today. Every one of us is using computer or a laptop. Computer is an electronic device that can perform a variety of operations in accordance with a set of instructions called program. It is a fast data processing electronic machine. Computer is a device that transforms data into an information. The computer, I do not need to explain in detail what is computer. All of us know as of now what is a computer, and we will discuss in detail how this computer has helped us out with respect to the accounting processes. Following are the characteristics of a computer. Number one, speed, storage, accuracy, diligence, versatility, communication, and processing power. What are the components of a computer? Number one is the data. When the data goes into the input, now it is being processed through a CPU and we get an output, which is called an information. What do you mean by data and what do you mean about information? So data is a raw data. Raw, what we collect from here and there is the data. What we get as an output is an information. Information is always a meaningful example of a data or meaningful of a raw data what we have input in the computer system. What are the characteristics of a computer? There are 7 characteristics of a computer. Number one, speed. Second is storage. Third is accuracy. Fourth is diligence. Fourth is versatility. Fifth is communication. And sixth is the processing power. Let me explain you about all these characteristics. Speed. The accounting entries or the entries which are being processed through the computer is being processed very quickly. That's how the speed help us out with respect to the passing an accounting entry. Second, storage. The computer can store the data. It is being stored in the hard disk of the computer. Therefore, going forward, after years of the passing an accounting entry, we can use such storage again to use that data whenever it is required. Third is accuracy. We discussed about errors and accounting errors which happens. And there could be totaling difference errors happening in the file passing an accounting entry. In the computer system, we can ensure there's an accuracy with respect to the totaling is there. The computer system is being designed such a way that it can calculate the amount with accuracy. Fourth is diligence. Diligence, the amount which is being prepared through the computer system is being done diligently. Fifth is versatility. Versatility means there are a number of things which can be used through a computer. Fifth is communication. The computer can be used through communicating the amount through a Gmail or through any other modes of communication. Last is processing power. If I talk about processing power, it can be correlated to the speed of processing the accounting entries. Let's now discuss about what are the components of the computer system. The computer system has got, when we put up the data into the input unit, the computer processes the same in through the storage and through the CPU. It generates the output, which is called information. Let's now discuss about what is data and what is information. Data is a raw information. What we collect from here and there and is not meaningful is called data. When the same is being giving a meaningful thing, it is called information. Therefore, the computer helps us as an accountant to process the accounting entries from a data to meaningful information. Let's now discuss about what are the limitations of a computer. There are majorly 5 limitations of a computer. However, it can be more. Let's now discuss what are the limitations of a computer. Number 1, cost of installation. 2, cost of training. 3, self-decision making. 4, maintenance. 5, danger for the health. What do you mean by cost of installation? As we all know, computer is a system which is bit costly. It can range from 10-15,000 to n number of rupees. Therefore, the installation of a computer is costly as compared to the manual accounting entries. After installing a computer, there again training is also required. Therefore, correct training is required to use the computer in a correct manner. 3, self-decision making. Computer misses the basic principle, which is self-decision making. As a human being, we can make a self-decision while passing an accounting entry or while doing any transactions. Computer is a machine. It cannot make any decisions on behalf of their own self. 4 is maintenance. Maintenance of a computer is required. To maintain the computer, there could be annual maintenance so that the machine is being utilized in a correct manner. Last is dangers for the health. The computer system can affect our eyes and it can affect to the health as well. Now, let's now discuss about what are the roles of a computer in the accounting. While recording a transaction in the respective accounting vouchers, there could be sales, purchase, and both the sale and purchase goes into the ledgers and the ledgers impacts our trial balance. So, after preparing a trial balance, there's a trading and a statement of profit and loss account and a balance sheet. All these accounting entries can be passed through the computer and the computer systems. What are the silent features of computer added systems? Number 1, it is simple and integrated. Number 2, transparency and control. 3, accuracy and speed. 4, scalability. 5, reliability. And last, performing various functions with accuracy. Let's now discuss about each characteristics. Number 1, simple and integrated. Computer can help us out with passing an accounting entry with simplicity. And it can be used through going forward through a storage devices as well. And it is integrated as well. While passing an accounting entry in a computer added systems, we can use these entries what we have passed today in future as well. And we can recheck if in case their error haven't happened. Number 2, transparency and control. What do we mean by controls? So it provides a sufficient time to plan, increase the data, accessibility, and enhances user satisfaction. 3, accuracy and speed. It provides user-definable templates, data entry schemes or forms for fast, accurate data entry of the transactions. The accounting entry can be processed through accuracy and speed both. 4, scalability. It enables in the changing the volume of the data processing in tune with the change in the size of a business. For example, the business has just started. However, business has increased to n number of turnover. The same computer can help us out with a 0 rupees of turnover to 1000 crore rupees of a turnover. 5, reliability. It makes sure that the generalized critical financial information is accurate, controlled and secured. Therefore, we can rely the accounting entries which has been processed through a computer and a computer added systems. Last, performing various functions with accuracy. Accounting software is used to perform the function of accounting. Therefore, the accounting is being processed with accuracy through a computer added systems. Let's now discuss about what are the softwares. So there could be one-time activities. Second is recurring activities. When we talk about one-time activities, It includes organization details, accounting years, type of ledgers, creation of a master file, and so on. When I talk about recurring activities, it could be entry of transactions and generation of the reports. So in the computer system, there are masters in place. And therefore, when we talk about one-time activities, we need to fit the accounting. One-time activities includes filling of the organization details, XYZ Private Limited. This is the accounting year. What are the type of ledger as per the accounting records? Creation of the master file as per the accounting records, and so on. Next is recurring activities, which include every transaction is being recorded in the accounting records and generation of reports as and when it is required. What are the silent features of computer as a system? Number one, password security. Second, data audit. Third, data vault. When I talk about password security, password is a mechanism which enables a user to access a system, including a data. The system facilitates defining the user right according to the organization policy. Therefore, the password security helps us so that our data is being protected from third-party users. Second, data audit. This feature enables us, one, to know who and what changes have been made in the original data, thereby helping and fixing the responsibility of a person who has manipulated the data, and also ensures data integrity. When we talk about data audit, there's a data log also being maintained in the computer data system. In case there are changes happen in a data log, we can get to know who has done the violation in the data log. Last is data vault. Software provides additional security through data encryption. Encryption essentially scrambles the information so as to make interpretation extremely difficult. What are the functions of a computer data systems? One is payroll processing, second is transaction recording, third are ledgers, fourth is trial balance, and fifth is preparing of the financial statements, which includes statement of profit and loss account, trading account, and the balance sheet at the year end. What are the advantages of a computer data systems? Let's discuss. We discussed about security, we discussed about scalability, large volume of transactions, timely reporting, lower cost, less paperwork, flexible reporting, queries handling, accurate and accuracy of the data, updation for and preparation of our financial statements. Therefore, the computer data system help us out in n number of ways. What are the limitations of the computer data systems? There are majorly four limitations of computer data systems. One is controls, second is data corruption, third is trained computer operations, fourth is limited of a software. When I talk about controls, a couple of minutes back, we discussed about the password security. If adequate controls are not built and where built are not followed, it can lead to loss of the data. It is important to take backups at the regular intervals to avoid such a situations. Next is the data corruptions. The data can be get corrupted through various that may come into the through the internet or the use of the external input devices without scanning them for the viruses. If the viruses come into the system, the data gets corrupted. Next is trained computer operators. We discussed a couple of minutes back what are the limitations in a computer. We need a trainings. Therefore, if we do not have a trained computer operators, therefore it can lead to a loss of a data. Last is limitation of a software. Every software cannot do everything. Therefore, a computer is dependent on a software, and we are dependent on how the software is going to perform. So every software has got pros and every software has got a cons. Therefore, there could be some limitation of a software as well. So let's discuss about accounting information systems. It includes revenue, expenditure, conversions, and administrations. When I talk about revenue, it talks about sales, cash collections, and sales returns. Expenditure, it talks about purchase returns, cash disbursement, and the payroll. Conversion, planning, resource management, and logistics. Administration, it includes capital, investment, and general ledger. Therefore, the accounting information systems help an organization to manage the whole accounting process of an organization, which by through revenue, expenditure, and the administration of the overall accounting of the organization and planning well of the accounting entries. Therefore, there are subsystems of cash in bank, sales account, inventories, payroll accounts, fixed assets accounts, expense accounting, tax accounting, final accounts, costings, budget, managements, and purchase accounts. This is called subledgers of a main ledgers. Therefore, these subledgers contribute to the main ledgers and how the trial balance is being drafted for an organization. Let's now discuss about comparison about how the manual records were maintained and how the data has been maintained through a computer added systems. Let's talk about recording. In the manual process, recording of a transaction is through books of original entries. In the other way, the data content is stored in well-structured form. Classifications. Transactions recorded are further classified by posting into the ledger accounts. This results into duplicity. In the computer address systems, no data duplications are done. Summarizing. Transactions are summarized to produce trial balance by ascertaining the balance of various accounts in a manual process. However, in a computer address systems, the generation of a ledger accounts is not necessarily conditioned for preparing of a trial balance. Therefore, trial balance can be prepared even without generating the subledger accounts. Fourth, adjusting entries. It's very difficult to pass an adjusting entries while preparing a books of account as per the manual way. However, in a system of a computer added system, we really do not need to make any adjustments. Financial statements. The preparation of a financial statement is very difficult while preparing the books account as per the manual process. However, in the computer added system, it is very easy to prepare the books of accounts. What are the accounting softwares? There could be three ways of accounting softwares. One is ready-made software, another is customized software, third is tailor-made software. In fact, customized software and a tailor-made software is one or the same thing. Majorly, ready-made softwares, when I talk about ready-made software, there are n number of ready-made softwares in the market, which includes Tally, which includes SAP, which includes Oracle, which includes many more software, which are readily available in the organization in the market. However, this is very costly at the time of implementation and these are utilized. Other is customized and a tailor-made software. Generally, some of the organizations prepare their own software basis of the nature of the transaction and basis of the nature of the business of the company. Therefore, while making a decision of what type of software is being used, it is very important to know what is the nature of the business of a company. So, what are the factors affecting while deciding the what software needs to be done? Number one, it should be flexible. Second, cost of installation and maintenance. Third, size of an organization. Fourth, ease of adaption and the training needs. Fifth, expected level of secrecy. Sixth is exporting and importing data facility. The software should be very flexible so that it could be used and customized as per the user needs. Installation and maintenance should be less costly. Size of the organization also depends and it impacts how costly of the software to be implemented. Adaption training needs to be taken care of. Secrecy of the data needs to be maintained and exporting and the importing data should be done. So, there are various type of accounting entries which include data entry, data validation, processing and revalidation, storage, information and reporting, which is called Transaction Processing System, TPS. What is the need and requirement of a computer accounting? Why do we need a computerized accounting? Because there are n number of transactions, instant reporting, reduction in the paperwork, flexible reporting, accounting queries, online facility, scalability, accuracy, and securities. All these have been discussed in detail a couple of minutes back. To summarize, we discussed about computer-aided systems. What are the features of the computers, how the accounting entries are being processed in the computers, what are the limitations of the computer, what are the advantages of computers, what are the challenges we face while doing the transactions through a computer, what are the softwares which can be done, it could be customized, it could be tailor-made, it could be ready-made software, and while choosing any software, we should be there, it's a diligent process which software needs to be done. I hope, dear learners, you would have learned about this and you would have liked our thing. Thank you.